نستمع إلى محمد فارس والمسلم المنتج. تفضل.
Can religion teach us productivity? When we think about religions, we think about them as sort of beliefs, of rituals, of scriptures that perhaps give us meaning and purpose in life. But have we already considered that religion can also teach us how to be productive? Today I want to talk to you about something called spiritual productivity. The idea is that you can boost your productivity through the scriptures of religion and through the rituals of religion. And specifically today, I'm going to talk to you about a ritual that's been practiced for over 1400 years. And today, over a billion people practice it daily. And that is the Muslim prayer, the Salah. When you think about the Salah, it's a unique ritual. It has physical movement of standing, bowing, prostrating. It has ritual purification of washing yourself, washing your face, arms and feet. It has chanting and praying. It has meditation, mindfulness, being aware of what you're doing. It has meditation, and it also is done in a community in the mosque. It's a very complex ritual that brings about many aspects of meditation, or what is known as attentional training. And more importantly, this is done 5 times a day, every single day. So how does Salah boost our productivity? It does so through 5 ways. It helps us manage our time. It boosts our energy, improves our focus, manages our emotions, and manages our egos. I'm going to talk about these one by one. Salah as a time management. 5 times a day, every day, the Salah is set. At dawn, at noon, in the afternoon, at sunset, and in the evening. 5 times a day, the day is structured. This is what Jonathan Fields called in his recent book, Uncertainty, calls it the anchor of certainty. It's a ritual that is done daily and gives structure to your day. When you feel like spinning off in a million different directions, Salah comes and gives you that little structure you need to be able to manage your time. But also think about the first prayer. It starts at dawn, before sunrise. And if you ask any productivity guru there is in the world, they'll tell you the number one tip to be productive is to wake up early. And Salah trains you to wake up early every single day without fail, before sunrise. We did a small animation to show you how an early start to the day gives you that boost in productivity. So that quick animation was to give that impression that having an early start to the day, just by the ritual of prayer, gives you the head start to the day. And as I said, ask if you look at the successful men and women of history, they have one thing in common. They all woke up early. The next is that Salah helps improve our focus. If you think about the actions of Salah, it gives you, you have to think about those actions. Think about the words you say. Think about where the state you're in. This is called attentional training, and it's an exercise for your brain. And in today's world, where you have to be distracted by Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, BlackBerry, everything, having that focus, that 5-10 minutes of your day, just to focus on your salah, is an immense, important training for the brain. and it helps you once you leave that prayer to go and focus on the salah, to focus on your tasks. The next is that salah helps also to manage our emotions. We're human beings, and as human beings, we go through ups and downs. We get angry, we get happy, we get sad. Again, prayer comes during the certain times. Let's say you had a very stressful morning, suddenly noon prayer comes, and that helps you to manage your emotions, control your emotions, and get to a state of calmness. That is repeated 5 times a day to help manage your emotions. And as a productive person, you have to be able to manage your emotions. You cannot let your emotions control you. You have to be able to control your emotions, and this ritual comes in and teaches that. Next is energy management. As I said before, prayer comes and teaches you to, there's physical movement, there's action, there's going to the mosque, it's a boost of energy. It's got physiological, psychological impact on the body, on the soul, on the feeling. It gives a boost of energy. It's not a distraction. It's not a break. It's actually a boost of energy. And again, we did a quick animation to show how salah can be really a boost of energy during the different times. So there you have it, a daily 5 ritual energy booster to keep you productive during the day and help you go on and achieve your work. Finally, prayer comes as ego management. We all have egos. We all like to think we're the best, that we know everything. But salah comes and tells you to bow down, to prostrate, put your head on the ground and say, I'm human, to be humble. And that's important, because if you're humble, you'll be able to wake up and learn. You'll be able to wake up and admit mistakes and say, maybe I wasn't right, maybe I was wrong. And that's also important to help you manage your egos and be able to become productive. So can religion teach us productivity? The answer is yes. But we need to stop thinking about religion as simply cultural heritage, but divine wisdom that is there to help us live our modern lives. Thank you very much.
TEDx. TEDx. والله البنات نايمين. TEDx.